Dear friends in Christ, we have come together in the presence of God, our Heavenly Father, to give Him thanks and praise for the gift of His Son, our meek and righteous King, who by His death became our Savior from sin and eternal death. By His Holy Spirit, may He enlighten, govern, and direct us that we may ever remain faithful to this righteous King and Savior and not be offended by His humble form and despised word, but firmly believing in Him, obtain eternal salvation and the fullness of joy in heaven. To this end, may God the Father grant us His grace through our Lord Jesus Christ. Daughter of Zion, surely your salvation is coming.
Rejoice, daughter of Jerusalem.
The Lord will cause His glorious voice to be heard.
And you shall have gladness of heart.
Give ear, O shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock.
Stir up your strength and come and save us.
Unto us a child is born. Sing to the Lord a new song.
For He has done marvelous things.
Thank you.
The lesson from Luke chapter 2, beginning at verse 15. So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told them.
Thank you.
The lesson recorded in Psalm 24, beginning at verse 7. Lift up your heads, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O you gates, lift up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory.
Thank you.
The lesson recorded in the prophet Isaiah, the 9th chapter, beginning at verse 2. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Who loved us all.
reading from Titus chapter 2, beginning at verse 11. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that, denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in the present age, looking for the blessed hope and glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from every lawless deed and purify for himself his own special people, zealous for good works.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you that of your mercy and compassion, you caused your Son to become incarnate, and through him redeemed us from sin and everlasting death. We beseech you, enlighten our hearts by your Holy Spirit, that we may ever be thankful for such grace and comfort ourselves thereby in all tribulation and temptation, and at last obtain eternal salvation through the same your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one true God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And